But right now, the main order of business, ladies and gentlemen, is for a huge, big, huge Pittsburgh welcome for Nuallan.
Hi there. How are you? Good. Good. We're really happy to be here in Pittsburgh. Thanks for having us. We came in yesterday, I guess, and we're having a great time seeing the sights and that kind of thing. But it's lovely to be in such a nice room this evening, too, to see a good turnout. I heard the competition was great today. Congratulations to all the competitors all around. So So as our host said, we're from Cape Breton Island. We might just give you a little bit of background or more background as the night goes about where we come from and why we do what we do. And but we might just carry on first into some more tunes. We'll play a march dress bass and reel. The first tune, the march, was written by a good friend of ours, Ryan MacDonald. She lives in Victoria, BC now, but she's a great piper. Grew up in Cape Breton, and she wrote it years ago at the Gala College, which is a place where they have summer camps for traditional music, and they used to have this competition for writing tunes for the students, and she submitted this one and won the competition that year. So she wrote it for my brother, Angus MacKenzie, and we'll carry on into some other tunes after that. Maybe some different versions of tunes you might have heard, Burke-Conroy, and some reels that I'm not good with names at the best of times. So we'll try that out. We'll see you after.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, so we couldn't be happier to be here, really to be at a piping competition. It's a little intimidating for me. It's been a while since I've been around competitions and things like that, and it's also really welcoming too, because I know how many of you know the instrument, know the music, and it's really exciting to share a bit of our style, a bit of rhythm, and share that with you. And just kind of listening to what George was saying at the start about how the world needs more pipers. It's really nice to have a big room full of pipers and drummers and all around and enthusiasts and parents. If there's any piping parents in the room, I don't know how you do it. Give a big round of applause for any parents who are hauling drums and all of that stuff. So we're gonna hand the floor over to Kevin. Would you like to say anything? Okay, so Kevin's gonna do a number.
Thank you.
All right. Way to go, Kevin. Thanks for the break. We're going to make Kevin play some more. We're going to bring out a couple of dancers. We have Brittany, Maniet, and Andrew Hoffman. We're going to do the Highland Laddie, I believe. Where are you guys from? Let's give Kevin a bit of a breather. Are you from Pittsburgh? Yep. Yeah. Cool.
Be good.
Thank you to the dancers. That was great. So at home, as we were saying before, the music and culture and language, Gaelic language, everything's fairly strong there still for the last, I don't know how many generations since the first Scots arrived, first Gaels. But these days, kind of fiddle is our main instrument, so we might play a fiddle tune now, if that's all right. I think we'll start off with a tune by Liz Carroll, a great American-Irish fiddler, by the name of the Air Tune. That's the name I have on it. And George requested this. Where's George? Somewhere, hiding. I think Dr. Eng, you recorded this as well, didn't you? Dr. Angus, one of our judges today, the esteemed Dr. Angus, recorded this on his last album, I think, right? Yeah. Might and Do and Donis, the second album. Yeah, so we'll play that one, and then we'll see where we end up after that. But the first one's a Liz Carroll tune. Thank you. All right, so we're gonna get Mac Morin up. Mac Morin's our keyboard player, right here. So for us, in our music, dance is absolutely central to the music and the rhythms and the expression that we play with. Everything revolves around the dance, and you're trying to get dancers up on the floor, or you're trying to help them with their dancing. But the dance is really central, and it kind of it keeps our music on kind of the straight and narrow. So we're gonna have a sample of that, and I'll cut it off there. But Mac Morin's a great step dancer, a big favorite at home, so I'm sure you'll enjoy.
Thanks so much, Mac. Great stuff. All right, we're going to get the Highland Pipes out again and play a track off of our CD, which we don't have with us today, but you can go online and download the album easy. This is a track called The Great Buck. We're starting off with kind of a slow 6/8 march, really old march from one of the Glenn collections, I believe. And then we're going to continue into some strats, bays, and reels after that. So I hope you enjoy this one.
Thank you.
So we had Bebe Duffus and Sheila Clarke jump out there for some. We're gonna play one more set for you before the break. And this is a set that our good friends in the band Shaitan recorded. And we have a bit of a connection with Shaitan. So Shaitan is a group in Scotland of pipers, and they kind of formed together through Hamish Moore, a great pipe maker from over there. And just last year, or the year before? Last year, Hamish also made us four matching sets of A pipes, which we're playing tonight. They're modeled off an old set that he found in the Inverness Museum from 1716, I think. But they're gorgeous, we think, anyway. A big thanks to Hamish Moore for that. So last year at the Celtic Colors International Festival, we got together with Shaitan and did kind of a combo thing. So this was one of the sets we learned from them. It starts off with the big Strass Bay called Tulloch Garam, and John Morrison of Ascent House, and Alex E. McGregor for the final one. So three great tunes, and they're from Shaitan's album if you want to check them out. And we'll see you at the break, or after it, or anytime.